Hello. Today in this lesson 6, let us learn some sentences in simple past present tense. I would request you to watch the previous lessons to learn Kannada effectively. Now, here are a few sentences. If you want to say, like, I go to school. So, how will you say that? I already, we know, nanu. To school means shalege. Shale is a school. Hogu means go. Hogutene means I go. So, nanu shalege hogutene. I go to school is nanu shalege hogutene. I eat fruit. Nanu hannu. Look at capital N here. N. Hannu tinnutene. I am fine. Nanu chennagi. Iddini. So when we talk, how it becomes Channagiddini. Actually, it is made up of two words, Channagi Iddini. But while we say it is Channagiddini, means I am fine. Nanu Channagiddini. Or you could even say Nanu Saukhyavagiddini. We go home now. Navu we Iga. Iga means now. Iga Manege. Hoguteve. See, here it was singular. Nanu hogutene, nau hoguteve. So it's very easy to follow. We go home now. Nau iga manege hoguteve. I do my work. Nanu nanna kelasa madutene. Doing the work. Kelasa means work. Madutene means I am doing the work. And nanna means mine. Nanu, I. I do my work. Nanu nanna kelasa madutene. We listen to the music. Navu sangeeta kelutteve. Navu sangeeta kelutteve. They watch the drama. Avaru nataka nodutare. See, kelutare means listening. We listen, sorry, kelutteve. So, noduttare means watching. They watch. Okay. Now, let's see how to construct some sentences in a very simple way. For this, I will take you through this first table. Pay attention here. I do means in Kannada, nanu. Maduttene. The capital D is for the D sound. And for sound clarity and pronunciation, please watch video 1, like first video where I have given the alphabets and of Kannada and swaras and vyanjanas and how they are pronounced. So that will help you a lot. So capital D means D. Don't read it as madutane. It is maduttene. Maduttene. Okay. So we do. Nau madutteve. He does. Avanu maduttane. She does. Avalu. ಮಾಡುತ್ತಾಳೆ ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಅದು ಮಾಡುತ್ತದೆ ದೇ ಡು ಅವರು ಮಾಡುತ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಫಾರ್ ಅವೇ ಇವರು ಸಂಬಡಿ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ರೆಫರಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ಕ್ಲೋಸರ್ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಟ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಬೈ ವಿ ಸೇ ಇವರು ಮಾಡುತ್ತಾರೆ ನೌ ಕೀಪಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಮಾಡು ಈಸ್ ಟು ಡು ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ ಯು ಡು ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ So, now I have given some verbs. Just pay attention here. It's very simple. For to sleep, if you are to say, malagu. Stand means nillu or nintuko. To sit, kudu or kulituko. To sing, haadu. So, again capital D here. Pay attention. Then, to eat, tinnu or unnu. Na, na. Capital N here, see. Then, to write, bare. To read, odu. See, this D is small, so the sound is the, odu. To go, hogu. Means to go. To come, baru. Barutene, ba. So, ba is the root word. Then, to get up, elu, l. Not elu, l, elu. To get up. To fall means beelu. Again, see L, capital L. Beelu. Forget. To forget means mare, mareu, mare. To remember, nene or nenapisu or nenapisiko. Now you may feel ki these are separate and these are separate. How are we going to make a sentence? Very simple. Now say for example, nanu madutene. I will replace this madu with malagu. So the sentence when I say nanu malagutene means I sleep. So simple. Now if I say I stand, how I should say nanu nillutene or nanu nintu kollutene, nanu kuduttene, nanu kulitu kollutene, nanu haduttene, I sing. Now if I want to use the next one like we do, nau maduteve. So suppose I say we sing, so nau haduteve, nau tinnuteve, we eat, or nau unnuteve. Generally eat is for snacks and breakfast and fruit we use, and unnu means it's a proper meals like, you know, dinner and lunch and all that. So uta unnu. Then nau bareyuteve means we write. Suppose I want to say he avanu madutane, this form I am taking, so I am replacing it with odu. So avanu odutane, he reads. Avanu hogutane, he goes. Avanu barutane means he comes. Now if I say she, take up she, so when I take she, what is the formation here? Avalu madutale, so madu I am replacing. Okay, avalu eluttale, she gets up. Avalu biluttale, she falls down. Avalu baruttale, she comes. Avalu mareyuttale means she forgets. It's so simple. Now if I take they, avaru maduttare, again madu I am replacing with, you know, mare or forget. So when I say, want to say they forget, avaru mareyuttare. And when I want to say they remember, so I will again they do. See here. So avaru or ivaru, again proximity, it depends on whether the person is close, they are close by or far away. So suppose I take ivaru, ivaru maduttare, so madu I am replacing by nene, so ivaru neneyuttare, ivaru nenapisuttare, they remember. So it is so simple. All you have to do is take any form of this, replace madu with any of these verbs, and you will get a new sentence. I hope you are enjoying learning Kannada with me. And if you have liked the video, please share and share with your friends, whoever is interested in learning languages. And it's always, you know, like very, very fascinating to know different languages. And whenever you speak to people in their own mother tongue, that connection is instant. I'm sure you all agree. Only those who are really interested will come to such lessons. So I wish you all the best and learn well, and I'll be posting more videos on this. I'm sure if you follow everything, every day practice for 15 minutes and you will speak fluently without any problem, and keep watching the news and, you know, Kannada movies or Kannada programs. And if people are around talking, then definitely you will pick up very fast. So like, share and subscribe. Thank you. Have a nice day.